Hello, this is Kevin with Bangard Inc. And in this series, we're going to take a look at adding filters and prompts to report and kind of the differences between them. So to get us started, I'm in my interactive custom report writer already. Here's a report that we've been working on through all the prior sessions so far. So I'm going to go into edit and we'll start with that same report. So basically it's the same report where we have all our, you know, jobs and vendors and invoices and so forth associated with those jobs. So in this video, I want to take a look at something called a filter and something called a prompt. A filter is something where we can filter data that when a user goes to run the report, they really don't get control over or changing that prompt or changing that value. It just basically, you know, does whatever it's taught for that particular filter. Versus a prompt is something that the user can interact with it to select what date range or what job range or something of that nature to define what data they want to use in their reporting. Looking at this report, since this report is really a list of invoices by job, I really don't want this job to be blank. So anytime that the job, I have any invoices that are not associated with the job, in this example, I don't want them. And I don't want the user that's going to use the report to be able to go back in and turn these on. I want to limit it to anything that's really got a job information. Now, to do this, I'm actually going to put the job number field in again to also talk about another topic calling, you know, we deleted columns earlier before, but we haven't hit a column and why hiding columns sometimes is important. So I'm going to go back and add another column here for the job number. Let's go into our attributes. Let's go down and find our job right there. So when I pick it, basically it just shows up here on the right-hand side for my new column that I just added. That's the one that I'm going to use for my filter at the moment. So I'm going to right-click. Oops, wrong side again. I need to do that from the defined side. So where's my job? Right here. So when I'm going to define, there's the job that I just added. This is the job that I've got the job number and description being, job description being put together. I could tell that because this says AP detail behind it for the one I just put in there. When I click on the down arrow on this, I can get to the filter here, where I should be to say that it is not equal to a blank. And I might just say it's greater than something. If I go back to my refine then, that basically took that other line off of that one that did not have a job. So in this case here, I went and found the field that I just added. I went down to filter. I selected whatever my operator was, and I just said one, figuring that most job numbers are going to have multiple characters and anything's going to be greater than one at the moment. I can see that there's a filter on this report because of down here. This is also where if you added multiple conditions, invoice amount has to be greater than $100 or, you know, whatever other reasons I might put condition or filter on this report, it would show all the different filters down here. If you get a filter on the report that you don't want, or if you need to modify it for some reason, if I hover over this line, it'll show me basically that job field is greater than one. I could hit the edit here to actually edit that to modify the values if I need to. I could also go over to the X and actually just flat out delete it. Then when I go back to my refine, you'll notice that that one that didn't have a job number is back on the list. So I really don't want that job to show up at the moment. So I'm going to go back and drop my filter back on. And we're going to say is greater than, well, I don't care about it. That's fine. Is greater than one. So it's got to have some sort of value. So then when I go to refine, basically shows me the report again without that invoice that didn't have a job associated with it. Now, I added this column because that's what I use for my condition. But ultimately, I've already got the job and the name over here that I really don't need that column to show up. So that's the difference in when I would delete a column, I don't need it in the report at all. Hiding a column would let me keep it in the report so I could still use it for filters or prompts or other reasons, but I'm just not going to show that value for some reason. So if I look at my refine here, I believe it is, there's a field that I want to look at. If I right click on it and say exclude column, that should take the column off the report map. So you notice that I don't have job in here anymore. But if I look at my define, I will still see it in this list here because it's still part of behind the scenes being used. So that way, if you write, I don't know, maybe you write some sort of formula on just show me all the invoices that are due in the next 15 days or something of that nature. But maybe I don't want to see a date or something, so I could turn it off and still use that in some sort of a filter for some reason. That's where exclude comes into play. So the next thing I want to take a look at is prompts. So prompts is something that a user can interact with. So in this case, you know, maybe I want to select what jobs, maybe I want to select what invoice dates I want this report to be looking for and so forth. So I'm going to go into my prompt tab here. And this is where we can basically set up what those prompts are. This little plus will let us create a new one. So column prompts are going to be some of the most popular because it'll just let you pick what field you've got in your report to base a prompt on it. Variable prompts are where you can actually create your own prompts. So I could say starting date and ending date and actually have my own prompt window off that. So the first ones I'm going to create here are going to be column prompts. And the first one I want to pick is a job. So title is going to be job, is going to be equal something from my choice list. When I look at refine, refine still shows me everything. When I look under prompts, if I've got any conditional prompts like I do here, this little preview will let me preview it as if I was running the report within, you know, the rest of the system. So I'm going to hit the preview here, and this is going to be where it's going to come up and say job. It's going to give me a list of whatever jobs are out there at the moment. So I'm going to check the box there. And I could do multiple jobs. Then when I say okay, then it should give me a report of just those two jobs and give me a total form. So that's kind of what the prompt does. Is a prompt is basically a method to condition the report down to what you're looking for. And if I left it blank, it's going to show me all my jobs. And let's add another one. Let's say I do want something to do with my invoice dates for some reason. So let's say I want it on columns. Let's say that I want my AP date. That was my invoice date there. Let's say that it is going to be between, and it's going to basically allow me to select from a calendar, so that should be fine. Let's see what that looks like. So now you'll notice that it lets me select a job if I want to, and then it allows me to put in whatever dates I want to put in for my conditioning. Let's double check what have I got here. So let's say it looks like I've got, what, maybe two invoices in, what is that, February of 2020? So let's go back then and let's say, maybe just that one month range there. And you notice that now it's going to show all the invoices for that particular month. So that's pretty much what the prompts do. So the prompts are a method that allows you to condition your data down to what I want to see instead of seeing all the data like we've seen so far. And that concludes this session. And thanks for watching.